Hey little yammers, welcome back to our second video for our YouTube channel. So today we're going to focus on a few things we did in our last video, so if you haven't checked out that video yet, please get on and do that. Then we're going to also cover a few different techniques today, including some elbows, and we're going to try and do a little bit of stuff. Really hope you enjoy the video. As always, make sure you've got some safe space around you, make sure you've asked your parents permission before you're doing this, and make sure you've got a drink ready to go. Let's do it! Hello little yammers. So firstly, thank you so much for checking out this video and spending some time getting some practice in while we currently can't get to class. Try as best you can to keep this up as many times a week as we can. You can watch this video as many times as you want and go through and just keep practicing so we keep our skills nice and sharp, working towards getting our next grade. Couple of things I want you to make sure you do. Firstly, make sure you're in your uniform, get your suit on, get your belt on. Secondly, make sure you've got enough room around you to train. You're in my garden today while the weather's nice, but if I need to go inside, I've got a space where I can train inside as well. And thirdly, make sure you've got a drink. Try and go through everything today. If you do need to pause for any reason, you can do that. Do whatever you need to do and get straight back to it. All right then, let's begin. Hi guys, right, so let's begin. Ready positions. Attention, and bow. Fantastic. So we'll go through a little warm up together, go through exercises as normal, and to make sure we're nice and warm before we start doing any of our techniques. So let's start very gently by jogging on the spot. So during this video, I'll take you through the first part of the exercise and I'll do some of it with you. But other than that, I'll try and count along, try and encourage you to keep moving. Let's just take our feet nice and gently in and out like this. Great stuff. Make sure we're breathing, taking nice deep breaths. Okay, let's try this one then. So try to take your feet forwards and backwards on that spot. Great, keep going forwards and backwards. Brilliant. Now put your hands behind your backs and you're going to bring your heels up at the back. So I'll show you from the side, so it should look a little bit like this. Brilliant. Keep that going. Keep bringing those heels up. Keep bringing them up. 5 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Put your hands out in front of you. Take a deep breath and then just bring your knees up. Good stuff, so keep bringing those knees up nice and high in front of you. Remember to keep breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth, where those knees are coming up. Keep that going. Breathe, 2, 1, brilliant. Okay, so you bring your feet together. Now this one you might need to be a bit careful of, make sure you've got room to do this, but we're just gonna do a step to one side, touch, step to the other, touch. So very, very small little steps and little touches of the floor, making sure we're bending our knees to get down to the ground. That's it. Boom. Down, keep that going. Down, down, brilliant. Down. We'll do 5 more, 4 more, 3 more, 2 more, and last one, and then back to a jog. So when you're jogging, keep those arms moving. Brilliant. Now what we're going to do is take one of our arms and we're going to do nice big circles. And then take the other one. Nice big circles again, being very careful. I've got lots of room out here, but you guys need to be careful of the things around you. Take both hands, bring them forwards. And then take both hands backwards. Excellent, good. So we freeze it there. Give it a little shake. So if you have done like I've done, you've come all untucked, just tuck yourself back in, pull your belt tight. If you want a quick drink, I'll give you a 30 second break to go and grab one. Always important to hydrate whenever we're training. Little and often is always a good idea. So don't go gulping too much and try and have something flat. So no fizzy drinks. Okay guys, come on back. All right, so let's go through our four basic exercises, the ones that we know. So we'll start with star jump position. So when I shout star jump position, just like you normally would in class, if you're sat down, I want you to jump up, feet together, hands by your side, then you're going to shout yes sir. So we'll do it. You ready? Star jump position. Yes sir. Wonderful. So I'll count for you and you guys start jumping along with me at home. Here we go. 1, and I still want you to hear you count back. 1 sir. 2 3 4 5 6. Keep that going. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Fantastic. Now, I know I usually encourage you to shout super loud in class, but please respect the people in your house and your neighbours too, so no shouting too loud. So stay in that starting position. Let's stay focused. In order to challenge ourselves today, let's try and do 10 more in our own time. I'll do these ones with you, so 10 more. When you finish, just call out 10, sir. Here we go. Fantastic, so give it a shake. Brilliant, so the next one we'll move to is push-ups. So again, make sure you've got lots of room around you. I won't go down to the push-up position today. It's a little bit wet on the floor. In fact, I'll show you one. I'll turn to the side. So remember, balls of your feet, hands on the floor, body in a straight line, down and up. But of course, we can drop to our knees when we do our push-ups. Get yourself down there in that press-up position. I'm gonna count for you 10 of our best. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, keep it counting. 4, 4, sir. 5, 5, sir. 6, 6, sir. Keep pushing it. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Fantastic, brilliant stuff. All right, you guys, jump up to your feet. Give those arms a shake. Do our next one then. So whenever you're unsure how to stand in classes, we remember resting position is just like this. So your hands behind your backs. One hand and the other. Fantastic. So we'll do squat position next. And we'll try and do a few squats to make sure our legs are super warm for our kicking today. So when I shout squat position, you can take your feet apart, boom, boom, hands across the front of your chest, and you're gonna shout, sir. Now, if you're training with your brothers or sisters or siblings or anybody else in your family, try and be the first one to get there. Here we go. Squat position, sir. Brilliant. So keeping those back straight, dropping down, getting nice and low as we go into our squats. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, down low, good. 4, boom. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Brilliant, hold there, let's go. Another 10, I think, so another 10 in your own time. Remember, get nice and low, and when you reach that number 10, big call out for me. Go, so 10 more, down, up, so pump it like that. Keep moving, make sure you're getting low, don't rush them. And then when we hear that final one, I wanna shout 10, sir. So I know that you finished. Excellent job, you guys, well done. Last exercise we'll do today then is for our tummy muscles, for our stomachs. So get yourself down to the ground now for me. Let's just sit legs crossed, hands on knees. Make sure there's space behind you as we're gonna fall back in a moment into our crunch sit-up position. All right, laying back, crunch sit-up position. So feet in the air crossed, hands by the side of your head. And again, we're gonna try and do 10. Remember, pulling your head and shoulders off the ground. So parents, if you're there helping and watching, you can make sure their form's correct on this one. Here we go to my count, and 1, pull it up, 4, and down. 2, really try and flatten those tummy muscles. 3, up and back. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, keep it going. 9, last one, and 10. Fantastic job, you guys. Really, really well done. All right, you get a 30 second break. Grab yourselves a drink. Okay guys, brilliant job on your warm-up. Let's get ourselves stretched so we can start doing some techniques. So, depending on your space, you can either do this one stood up or you can do this one sat down, so whichever you prefer. I'm gonna stand up today to try and keep myself dry. But if you're at home and you've got the room, sit yourselves down, legs out into that V shape. So even if you sat or your legs are just like mine, your legs should stay straight, remember, and try and have your toes pointing up or away from you. Take a deep breath in. Feel those lungs. We're going to come down our body and then you're going to go down your left leg and go as far down towards your toes as you can. And then leading with your chest, try and get that in towards the top of your leg and heading towards your knee. And you guys can count down with me from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Deep breath in as you reach up high again. And then we're going to come down and then we're going to go down the other leg. And again, try and lead with your chest in towards that top of the thigh, head down towards the toes. We'll count down from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. Deep breath in. And now I want you to reach straight down the middle, or either hands on the floor like mine, or you're reaching forwards in between your feet. Brilliant. And we're gonna hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back up again. I would like you to walk your feet in just a little bit. Turn them to face outwards, so they're not forwards. And if you're sat down for this one, you need to jump up to your feet. bend your knees, and I want you to push either with your hands or sometimes with your arms, works a little bit better. Just push out and then just sit your middle down and you'll get a stretch just here on your groin. Brilliant. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back up again. Deep breath in, put your feet together. And last one, down and to your toes. Good stuff, and come back up. Okay, give your legs just a little shake. We'll just do one for our arms. I know we don't usually do it, but let's have a quick go today. I want you to take your left arm, put it up high like this, bend it so it goes down behind your head, reach up and grab your elbow, and then just pull it this way a little bit, and you'll feel a stretch just down here. And we hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So copy me exactly this time. Your right arm up, bend it at the elbow, grab, pull it across, and hold it there. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, give me a little shake. Shake it out. And now we're ready to start some techniques. Okay, so let's go through our positions first of all. I'll show you the basic positions that we need, and then we'll do them together, and then we'll have a little race to see who can do them the quickest. So the ones that you need for your grading are as follows. Resting position, so copy along with me. Remember, that's one hand in the other, behind your back. The next position we need is ready position. So that's hands down in front of us, in those fists with those thumbs on the outside. Remember, when we do a tension, your left leg is going to come in to meet your right. And then when we do bow, we bend from the center. The next stance we need is horse stance. So again, when we do our horse stance, your left leg is going to step out, boom, boom, to here. Come back. And then when we do our guarding stance, it's your right leg that's going to go back behind you. And then we also need to be able to show a jump change and a jump change. So those are our basic positions that we need for our purple stripe belt. So let's go through again. This time, try and get there with me. Okay, so we go resting position. And remember, each one of these, I want you to call out, sir. Ready position, sir. Attention, sir. And then bow, sir. Left leg out for horse stance. Horse stance, sir. Fantastic. Come back to attention, sir. Now we're gonna go our right leg back for guarding stance. Guarding stance, sir. Jump change, sir. Jump change, sir. And then we're back to our resting. Brilliant. One more time with me, then I'm gonna call them out, see if you can get there, okay? So we start resting position. Ready position. Attention. Bow. Horse stance. Resting position. Guarding stance. Jump change. And jump change. And then we're back to our resting. Fantastic job, everybody. Okay, so one more time. I'll call them out for you. Let's see if you can get there. We'll do them in that order. Then I'm going to throw out some random ones, see if you can get there quickly too. Here we go. So, resting position. So that's wonderful. Hands behind your backs. Attention. Very good. So snap, stand tall. Bow. Keeping good eye contact. Fantastic. Horse stance. Left leg that steps out. Good. Back to resting position. So hands behind those backs. Guarding stance. So always right leg back. Jump change. Jump change and resting position again. Fantastic. Very, very good job. So let's do some elbowing then. So one of the elbows is one of my favorite striking tools because they're super powerful and we don't really have a lot of going on in our elbows. So we, you know, when it comes to the feeling that we get in our arm, you know, there's not many, very many nerve endings there. So they're real tough. So when we use them, we barely feel it, which is great for us. It means no injuries. So today I'm going to take you through a few different elbows. I want you to try all of them. So if you're a beginner, just gives you a chance to try some stuff that's going to be coming up for you. But if you've been training for a little while with us, it gives you a chance to practice all of your previous elbows. So bring your feet together, attention, and then bow forwards. We're going to go right leg back, guarding stance. So the first elbow we're going to do is what we call a hooking elbow. And it's called a hooking elbow because it follows the same line that hook punches do. So when you're a beginner, so white belts, purple belts, we do a rear hooking elbow. So you're going to bring your fist in towards your chest, your rear fist. So in this case, it's our right foot is back. This rear fist is going to come in. This hand's going to stay up. We're going to turn and bring our body around and bring that elbow around in front of us. Let's try and do 5 like that together. Here we go. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Excellent. Get ready for a jump change. Try and beat me. Jump change. Boom. Excellent stuff. So now with the left hooking elbows. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. job, you guys. Get ready for a jump change again. And jump change. Sir. Brilliant. So we were working from the rear. We're now going to do forward or front hooking elbows. So you should have your left foot forward. So it's going to be a left hooking elbow this time. Arm around in front of you and then back to guard. So same deal. Try and get it in towards your chest. Turn and bring it round. Notice that my front foot kind of pivots and turns too. Here we go. One. Two. Three. Four. And five. Great stuff. And then jump change. Perfect. Same again. This hand in. Turning over and coming round. Here we go. One. Two. Three. Four. And five. Fantastic job. Get ready for a jump change. And jump change. Perfect. So the next elbow we're going to do, just rest, is what we call an upward elbow. So this time, rather than following the hook part, the path of a hook punch, we're now going to put our elbows pointing up towards the sky. Now, these can do a couple of things. They can be a strike, but they can also block, so they can cover. So if something's going to hit us, boom, we can use the side of our arm to cover and chain and protect our head. So, in guarding position, we're going to do rear ones first. So we're going to go up, almost bring the hand past your head, elbow up. Now, if you look from behind, my hand almost kind of goes right down my back. Boom, so then the elbows point right up high into the sky. So, upward elbows, and then back to guard. Making sure we keep this other hand up high. Let's try and do five. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five. Brilliant. Jump change, sir. Wonderful. So this time, with the left up nice and high. Here he comes. Ready. One, two, three, four, five. Very good job. And then jump change. Brilliant. So same thing again. We do it from the rear, but we also have to learn this one from the front. So with the front here, same thing goes down, points the elbow up, and then back. So boom, here we go. To my count, ready. One, two, three, four, five. And then jump change. Excellent stuff, you guys. One more set, ready. One, bring that front elbow up. Two, three, four, and five. Wonderful job, jump change. Fantastic. So we're going to do one more set. This time I'm going to challenge you a little bit to try and do a combination. So a combination means more than one. So for you guys, as you'll know, we all know the jab and the cross. We put it together, it becomes a combination, jab, cross. So a double punch. So we're now going to do two elbows. So we're going to go hooking elbows first. We're going to go front hooking elbow, then rear hooking elbow, and we're going to shout Tia Tia. So if we come from our attention position, right leg goes back, guarding stance. We're going to go front hooking elbow, rear hooking elbow. So it looks like this, Tia Tia. So we're going to try and do two elbows. Let's try and do five to my count. Guards up, elbows in. Looking down the camera, here we go. One, boom, boom. Nice, so Tia Tia for me. Two, front, rear. Good. So it should be your left one first. The foot that's closest to me should be your left one. That's the one we should be going with first. Three. So TT is the shout. Four. Excellent. Five. Let's do one more for luck. Six. Great stuff. And then jump change. Great job. So this time, right one first, left one second. Again, we're going to shout TT. Guards up. Here we go. One. Nice. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Wonderful. Get ready for a jump change. Ready? And jump change. Brilliant job, you guys. Let's do one more combination. This side, rising elbow from the front, rising elbow from the rear, and then back to guard. So you're going to go front, rear, rising elbows or upward elbows. So my count is trying to do five. So remember, left side first. Here we go. One. Nice. Two. Three. Four. Five. And jump change. Great stuff. Same again, up and up. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five. Excellent stuff. And jump change, boom. Brilliant, and come to resting. All right, you guys, so great job. So those were hooking and upward elbows. Spend some more time practicing them. Let's move on with some kicking then. So today, little yammers, I'm going to just focus on the students that we've currently got training. So in this particular class, we've got white grades, we've got purple grades, we've got yellow grades, we have got green grades. So we're going to go through those kicks. I'll demonstrate them, and then we're going to do a few sets. with me. Now, if you've got parents with your people in the room and you've got your own pads at home, this would be a great time to start using them. We're gonna go through a few of each so you make sure you understand them, but please, safety is key. Now we're starting throwing our legs around, doing our elbows and punches and things on the spot, so okay, because we're not, you know, using massive amounts of space, but now you're starting to throw your legs around, you need to be careful of the space you've got around you. So let's go through the kicks then. So for green belt, we'll work our way back. Green belt, they're doing what's called an axe kick. So when we do an axe kick, your back leg, so if your right leg comes back, comes up across you, it's gonna get nice and high in the air, and you bring your heel, boom, down. So you're striking the back part of the foot, and if you're holding a pad, you're coming down on top of that pad. So it comes up, boom, and you try and chop it down. Now we call it an axe kick, because it's almost like an axe in your hand that you pick up and use to chop wood, so it's kind of faster on the way down. Comes up, boom, and then down. So that's the one that our green belts are gonna practice. If you're a yellow gray, a yellow belt, we're gonna do what's called a push kick. So if you imagine how you push with your hands, if I was gonna push something, I want you to put my hands up here. They come in towards me, so my arms bend, and then I push out. And in fact, that's how I'm gonna generate power. We're gonna do the same thing, but with our legs. So if we've got our right leg back, we bring our knee up in front of us like this, and then we push away. So we bend it in and push it out. So it looks like this. So we're using what's called the ball of our foot, which is the bottom part. So when you do this, if you're watching at home, you should be able to see the bottom part of my foot. Boom, so I'm pushing away. So knee up towards the chest and push out. Boom, those are our push kicks. If we are a purple grade today, we're gonna do a turning kick. So the same movement you use as you do a front kick, we're just gonna have our hips in a slightly different position. So the way we get there is we open our front foot and allow our hips to kind of turn over. So rather than having them up like this, like a front kick would be, we turn our hip, we'll turn our foot and then brings our leg over. Then when it's over in this position, boom, you snap out a kick and then bring it back down again. So foot opens this way, boom, snap out a kick and back. And then lastly, for our white grades, we can do that front snap kick that we've been learning. So, right leg comes up, snaps out in front and back. So we'll show it from the side. From here, bring your knee up in front of your chest, snap out your kick, back and down. So up, snap, back and down. So, axe kicks for the green belts, push kicks for the yellow, turning kick for the purple, and then front snap kick for our white grades. We're gonna do it to my count. Make sure you've got that room. Guided stance, and I'll count you off. Here we go. One. So we should hear a sound, nice crisp, and then back to guard. Two. Fantastic. Three. Four. And five. Wonderful. So you should be here, jump change. Keep your guard up high, chin down, elbows in. So same thing now, we should be with your left leg. So you should all have your left leg back behind you. So you should be the same as me. This hand hits down that left leg, which is back behind you. Run that kick, here we go. One. Two, three, four, five. Great stuff, and jump change, perfect. All right, so let's do that again, because the key to getting good at anything is repetition. Keep practicing, keep practicing, keep practicing. So this time, I want you to work on keeping your guard up. A lot of times when I watch students train, this kind of thing happens. The hands drop down as they kick. So let's focus this round and keeping their guard up nice and high. Here we go. So your kicks one more time. So remember, green belt axe kick. Get it nice and high now. Pull it down fast. Yellow belts want to see the bottom of that foot facing towards the screen. So as if you're showing me that your feet are nice and clean as you push away. Turning kicks, remember to turn your hip all the way over. And after you kick, chamber. So that means bend it back in before it goes down. The same with our white belts. Boom, after you kick, chamber back in. Here we go. Let's try and do another five on each side. Ready? And one, two, three, four, five, six. Great stuff. And jump change. Same on the other side. Here it comes. And one, two, three, four, five, and six. Good. Jump change. Perfect stuff. Okay, and rest for me. So, the next part of this training, you're going to do on your own. So you can either pause this video, which I suggest you do, and then you're going to go and run and do those ones again. So if there's someone in the room with you, they can count for you, especially if they're holding a pad, and give you a target to aim at. But we've only just done pretty much kind of like 10 to 12 kicks on each side. That's not enough if we're going to improve enough to get our new grades. So do those again and again. So do another couple of sets on each side until you feel like you've progressed and you've gone a little bit further today than when you started. So let's finish today's online session with a nice, easy, basic self-defense technique. So remember, what self-defense techniques mean are, is that if somebody wants to try and hurt us or hit us in a certain way, how would we deal with that? How would we react? So it's not just enough that someone's trying to hit us and we're trying to block and move. This could be that someone's actually putting their hands on us. So it could be grabbing us around the wrist. It could be grabbing us on the shirt. It could be sneaking up behind us and grabbing us in a bear hug. So these are the sort of things that we're going to be practicing. So today we'll do a nice, easy, basic one. And this is from the White Grey curriculum. If you've got somebody at home you can train with, great. Pull them up now, make sure you bow, make sure it's a safe space to do it. If not, you can do it like I'm going to do it, like a kata, so on my own, as if someone's grabbing me. So what we're going to imagine is someone is reaching forwards and they're grabbing our right hand. So your right hand's out like this and they're grabbing hold of it. So they've got their thumb and fingers around your wrist. Okay. So what we're going to do here, at the moment, if you imagine my hands like on a clock, the hands of a clock. So my fingers are now pointing down towards 6 o'clock. If I bring my hand up, it now points to where 9 o'clock is on the clock, and I keep going, it's now pointing to where 12 o'clock is, okay? So that's the direction I want you to go. You're gonna do a circle, and then you're gonna bring your hand all the way down back to here. Good, so again, as a partner grabs, you come up, you circle, and around. That's really important, you get nice and high, so that we can go over the top of our partner's wrist. We don't wanna be underneath, we need to go over the top of our partner's wrist. Now what this does, it makes it very, very difficult for our partner to keep a grip on us if we do this correctly. So again, big circle, out and round. Fantastic, be able to grab this side, I do the circle in the other direction. Okay, so they grab here, circle, try and copy with me. Imagine they grab here, boom, we come up, circle. Brilliant. We grab here, circle, grab here, circle. So if you have got a partner, let them put their hand on you, boom, come up, try and circle off. And just keep that going, boom, until the hand pops out. Some of you might, partner might let go here, some of you here, some of you might take to here because some people are real flexible in their wrists. But eventually, I promise you, it will come off. So one more time, let's go right hand, the person grabs, circle in front, other person grabs, circle in front. Now what you are doing with this circle is you're going across in front of your face. Okay, so not this way. Okay, across in front of your face now, across in front of your face now. All right, so practice that one again. Great job with the partner.